The given function has one critical number. We want to find the critical number, then determine if there is a relative max or min at that x value, then determine the relative max or min value. In order to find the critical numbers of the given function, we want to determine where the derivative of the function is equal to 0 or undefined. And because we have a product of two functions, we'll have to apply the product rule given here to find our first derivative. So f prime of x is equal to the first function, quantity 2x minus 1, times the derivative of the second function, which is the derivative of e raised to the power of negative 6x, plus the second function, which is e to the power of negative 6x, times the derivative of the first function. Now let's go back and find our derivatives. F prime of x is equal to the quantity 2x minus 1 times the derivative of e raised to the power of negative 6x. To find this derivative, we'll have to apply the chain rule since this is a composite function using this formula here. So the derivative of e to the power of negative 6x is e to the negative 6x times the derivative of negative 6x, which is negative 6, plus e to the negative 6x times the derivative of 2x minus 1, which is 2. Let's go ahead and rewrite this by factoring out e to the power of negative 6x. That would leave us with the quantity 2x minus 1 times negative 6, and then just plus 2. Let's go and simplify this again. If we distribute negative 6, we would have negative 12x plus 6, but then we also have plus 2, so that would be 8 minus 12x. Notice how we could factor out 4 here. Let's go and leave it in this form. So this is our derivative function. We want to know when this is equal to 0 or when it's undefined. Well, it's never going to be undefined, and e to the power of negative 6 is never going to equal 0. So the only time this will equal 0 is when 8 minus 12x equals 0. So if we subtract 8 on both sides, divide by negative 12, negative 8 divided by negative 12 is equal to 2/3, which is our only critical number. So this is the first part of our question. But now we want to determine whether there's a relative max or min at this x value, and then also determine what that relative max or min value is. So we can either use the first derivative test or the second derivative test. For this example, let's go ahead and use the first derivative test. Otherwise, we'd have to find the derivative of this derivative function in order to use the second derivative test. So to use the first derivative test, since the domain of the given function is all real numbers, we're going to divide the real number line into two intervals using the critical number x equals 2/3. Again, since the domain of the original function is all real numbers, and our critical number is x equals 2/3, notice how we'd have two intervals, one to the left of 2/3 and one to the right. To the left of 2/3 would be the open interval from negative infinity to 2/3. To the right would be the open interval from 2/3 to infinity. Now we'll pick a test value in each interval, determine the sign of the first derivative, which will tell us whether the function is increasing or decreasing on the interval, and that'll give us enough information to determine whether we have a relative max or min at 2/3. Let's use x equals 0 in this interval for our test value, and let's use x equals 1 in this interval for our test value. So now we'll determine the sign of f prime of 0. So we'll substitute 0 for x. That would be e to the 0 times 8 minus 0, or 8, which is positive 8, which is greater than 0. So if the sign of the first derivative is positive, that means the function is increasing on that interval. And now we'll test to see what the sign is at x equals 1. So if x equals 1, we would have e to the power of negative 6 times the quantity 8 minus 12 times 1, or 12. This is going to be negative, or less than 0, which means on this interval the function is decreasing. So if we have a function that's increasing on this interval and then decreasing on this interval, that means at x equals 2/3, we have a relative maximum. So this means we have a relative max at x equals 2/3. And then to determine the relative maximum value, we need to find f of 2/3, which means we'll substitute 2/3 into the original function. So we'd have 2 times 2/3 minus 1 times e raised to the power of negative 6 times 2/3. So here we'll have 4/3 minus 1, or 4/3 minus 3/3, that's 1/3, times e raised to the power of negative 6 times 2/3, which is negative 4. So we can write this as 1 divided by 3 e to the 4th. So the relative maximum value is 1 divided by 3 e to the 4th, which is approximately 0.0061.
I do want to mention that sometimes we are asked to express the relative extrema as ordered pairs.
So to express this information as an ordered pair, again, the x-coordinate would be 2/3, and the y-coordinate would be 1 divided by 3 e to the 4th. But it's important to remember that the location of the relative max is actually the x-coordinate, and the relative maximum value is the function value, or the y-coordinate. And to verify this information, let's look at the graph of our function. Here's the graph of the function. Notice how I had to really zoom in on the function right around x equals 2/3, which would be right here. So that's the location of our relative maximum. We can see it is a high point. And that function value right there is 1 divided by 3 e to the 4th. So this graph does verify our work. I hope you found this helpful.